every time. Our Mass presider is Reverend Father Ronnie Crisostomo, SVD, Shrine Rector. Our celebration will now begin. Please stand.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Once again, we come before God, imploring His mercy upon us all, especially for our brothers and sisters who are suffering, countries, communities, because of this pandemic. We humbly implore God's mercy and pardon for all of us, for our world. And so, with confidence, at the beginning of this celebration, also invoke God's mercy and forgiveness. Together we pray, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Attend to the pleas of your people with heavenly care, O Lord, we pray, that we may see what must be done and gain strength to do what they have seen. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the first book of Samuel. During the time young Samuel was minister to the Lord under Eli, a revelation of the Lord was uncommon and vision infrequent. One day Eli was asleep in his usual place. His eyes had lately grown so weak that he could not see. The lamp of God was not yet extinguished, and Samuel was sleeping in the temple of the Lord, where the ark of God was. The Lord called to Samuel, who answered, "Here I am." Samuel ran to Eli and said, "Here I am, you called me." "I did not call you," Eli said. "Go back to sleep." So he went back to sleep. Again the Lord called Samuel, who rose and went to Eli. "Here I am," he said. "You called me." But Eli answered, "I did not call you, my son. Go back to sleep." At that time, Samuel was not familiar with the Lord, because the Lord had not revealed anything to him as yet. The Lord called Samuel again for the third time. Getting up and going to Eli, he said, "Here I am, you called me." Then Eli understood that the Lord was calling the youth. So Eli said to Samuel, "Go to sleep, and if you are called, reply. Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening." When Samuel went to sleep in his place, the Lord came and revealed his presence, calling out as before, "Samuel, Samuel." Samuel answered, "Speak, for your servant is listening." Samuel grew up, and the Lord was with him, and permitting any word of his to be without effort. Thus all Israel, from Dan to Beersheba, came to know that Samuel was an accredited prophet of the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will.
Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will.
I have waited for the Lord, and he stooped toward me and heard my cry. Blessed the man who makes the Lord his trust, who turns not to idolatry or to those who stray after falsehood.
Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will.
Sacrifice or oblation you wish not, but ears open to obedience you gave me. Burnt offerings or sin offerings you sought not. Then said I, "Behold, I come."
Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will.
In the written scroll it is prescribed for me, to do your will, O my God, is my delight, and your law is within my heart.
Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will.
I announced your justice in the vast assembly. I did not restrain my lips as you, O Lord, know.
Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will. Please stand to honor the gospel.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On leaving the synagogue, Jesus entered the house of Simon and Andrew with James and John. Simon's mother-in-law lay sick with a fever. They immediately told him about her. He approached, grasped her hand, and helped her up. Then the fever left her, and she waited on them. When it was evening after sunset, they brought to him all who were ill or possessed by demons. The whole town was gathered at the door. He cured many who were sick with various diseases and drove out many demons, not permitting them to speak because they knew him. Rising very early, before dawn, he left and went off to a deserted place where he prayed. Simon and those who were with him pursued him, and on finding him said, "Everyone is looking for you." He told them, "Let us go on to the nearby villages that I may preach there also. For this purpose I have come." So he went into their synagogues, preaching and driving out demons throughout the whole of Galilee. Dear friends, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to Lord Jesus Christ.
A blessed evening to everyone, especially to those of you who are joining us through our live stream Mass here at the Shrine of Jesus, the Divine Word. Saint Paul, in his letter to Timothy, second letter to Timothy, said once, "Preach the word. Be prepared in season and out of season." That was his instruction to his disciple Timothy, in charge of a community. And the proclamation of God's good news knows no special place nor time. Such perspective can be seen already in the very life's example of Jesus. If we pay attention a little bit to the setting and chronology of Jesus' activities, we notice that all moments and places are moments and places for his ministry. Ministry of doing good, of preaching the good news. There was no specific or special place for this. Absolutely any place where he was, any moment. Moment of preaching the good news. He called his first disciples, for example, on the shore of Galilee, in the place of their work, because they were fishermen. He did not wait to meet them at the synagogue, but there, in the very place of his work, of their work. Also, he went to the synagogue and taught there with authority over unclean spirits, and he cured them, expelling out these evil spirits from persons inhabited by these unclean spirits. Then he went to Peter's home, where he would heal his mother-in-law, who was sick. And it says there that at the door, it's just simply points there, at the door, probably the door of Peter's house, where the sick, the possessed with demons, gathered there to be healed by Jesus. So, places, every place where Jesus was, no, every moment was a moment to perform his ministry. In today's gospel, we heard that early morning, Jesus went to a deserted place to pray, to commune with his Father. While there was a demand for his service for people in need, he was also concerned of proclaiming the message of God, of the good news, to other places. So we see that in Jesus, his whole life has been permeated by the sole concern of bringing God's kingdom into a reality in the lives of people. He met and proclaimed the good news to them and his salvation and of God's mercy by liberating them from those that enslaved them, by healing them. All these moments of his life can be seen as always open to his Father. And all, he did all this for his Father's glory and for the salvation of his brothers and sisters. Christian life, too, is characterized by this radical openness to Christ. At every moment and at every circumstance of our life, there is no dichotomy between the Sunday of our worship to God and the weekdays of our work and engagement in daily human life. For these moments, these times, have been permeated by God's Spirit and God's grace with the coming of his Son as a human being like us. One difficulty we see in our Christian life is our tendency to separate, to dichotomize our lives. Sunday and moments of prayer are for God, while other moments we do not see God's role anymore there. As one puts it jokingly, Sunday is for God and the other days are for me and for the devil, someone said, no? The dichotomy, the separation of our life of worship and our engagement, daily engagement with life. That's why there is a wide gap between one's piety and one's option in life. Pious and prayerful on the one hand, but greedy, self-centered, without moral principles on other aspects and moments of their life. If we look at the life and example of Jesus, there is that core that provided consistency in his life. And that is his preoccupation in doing God's will and the will of the Father and the realization of God's kingdom. So in his ministry of preaching, of healing, in his relating with others, it is always motivated by making God's reign visible in our midst. And this is that made consistent Jesus in his living and in his ministry. The question, therefore, that we should be asking also is, what is the core that sustains my life, that should give consistency also of my prayer, of my relationship with God, and also my options in life? It is quite perplexing at times that people who are so good, so generous, for example, very faithful in doing what is supposed to be the religious obligations, which is of course excellent and it should be maintained, yet they cannot see the connection of this with their options. No. So our option for Christ, our option for the gospel, should lead us also to opt for those teachings of Christ, what Jesus stood for, like truthfulness, like selflessness, that should also be the principle that should illumine and guide our daily engagement in life. May our constant hearing of God's word, God's good news, lead us also to opt for those values and options of Christ to assist us and be our guide in our daily life. Amen. Like the people who brought to Jesus all who were sick or possessed by demons, we commend to our Heavenly Father all who are filled with pain and sorrow and in need of healing love. For every prayer, let our response be, Lord of compassion, deliver us.
Lord of compassion, deliver us.
That the Church may always rely on the Lord in trials and difficulties, we pray.
Lord of compassion, deliver us.
That the Lord may give hope and encouragement to the starving people of the world, especially those who are unjustly deprived of food, clothing, or freedom, we pray.
Lord of compassion, deliver us.
That those who suffer from depression and anxiety may find in Christ a sure anchor and refuge,
we pray.
Lord of compassion, deliver us.
For our frontline healthcare workers and other essential workers, that God may cover them with his mantle of protection, sustain them and give them strength as they perform their respective duties. May we have enough medical provisions, healthcare facilities, and other resources to use for everyone who need cure. We pray.
Lord of compassion, deliver us.
That those suffering through illness and who find life an intolerable burden may see Jesus in their trials, we pray.
Lord of compassion, deliver us.
That the dead and those who mourn their loss may find hope and comfort in the resurrection of Jesus, we pray.
Lord of compassion, deliver us.
And we pray for our other intentions. We pray.
Lord of compassion, deliver us. Almighty Father, watch over your family, protect us and keep us in your care. For all our hope is in you, we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrament at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
May your people's oblation, O Lord, find favor with you, we pray, that it may restore them to holiness and obtain what they devoutly entreat, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord,
Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In Him you have been pleased to renew all things, giving us a share in His fullness. For though He was in the form of God, He emptied Himself, and by the blood of His cross brought peace to all creation. Therefore He has been exalted above all things, and to all who obey Him has become the source of eternal salvation. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Fund of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Onesto our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, especially those we remember in this Mass, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints, who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. We now pray that God's kingdom, God's will for the world and for us, for all of us, may be accomplished. And so we pray the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Jesus, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Jesus, Word of love, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Jesus, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
The body of Christ.
Amen. Act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you're already there, and unite myself wholly to you. never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Please stand.
Let us pray. Humbly we ask you, Almighty God, be graciously pleased to grant that those you renew with your sacraments may also serve with lives pleasing to you. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Oratio Imperato. Merciful and compassionate Father, we come to you in our needs to seek your protection against the COVID-19 that has deserved and even claimed lives. We ask you now to look upon us with love and by your healing hand. Dispel the fear of the sickness and death. Restore our hope and strengthen our faith. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. We thank you for the vaccines developed made possible by your guiding hands. Bless our efforts to use this vaccine to end the pandemic in our country and the whole world. We pray for our health workers that they may minister to the sick in competence and compassion. Grant them health in mind and body. Strengthen their commitment and protection from the disease. We pray those who are afflicted, that they may restore to health. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in these trying times to work for the good of and the health of those in need. May our concern and compassion for each other see us through this crisis and lead us to conversion and holiness. Grant all this to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Amen. We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers. O glorious and blessed Virgin, Amen. Our Lady, health of the sick,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel,
pray for us.
San Roque,
pray for us.
San Lorenzo Luis,
pray for us.
San Pedro Calunsun,
pray for us.
Saints Arnold Johnson and Joseph Ferdinand,
pray for us.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, your loved ones, your work and activities, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Sa kanyang kaharian.